So I have a scar. They said that it was translated death and hate to the opponent. So we're off to a dang good start. Derby number two.
And look at these freaking cops coming down. It's go time. Game starts in like 2.5 hours. And this is the crazy thing, like, I'm at a soccer game.
What's good, everybody? It's 5:50 in the morning. And we're about 10 minutes outside of his apartment, so we're gonna go get a sleep for about 10 minutes. And then we're gonna get up again and go to the game. I came to see exactly how they do things, and this is what they're doing. They're going crazy in the morning, man. The ultras are meeting early. I don't know if I can film that. But here he comes. He's getting his keys from the apartment. He's sprinting, dude. He's been freaking hyped this whole time, driving for like 5 hours.
We got the supplies, yo.
The supplies.
I'm hyped, yo. Let's go. I gotta catch some sleep, though.
Guess like what, an hour?
Yeah, I'm gonna sleep like for an hour. Yo, the weather is rainy, bro. That's like perfect derby weather, yo.
Oh, we got some rainy derby weather. What does that mean?
It's just, you know, like the games are even more intense.
More
like
intense?
Rains, yo. It just fits the whole, like, you know, scenery.
Y'all ready? Are you sleeping or what?
No, can't beers.
You getting beers?
Where's the beer?
Let's go. We're going to bed for an hour and a half. But the Scottish boy does not want to go to bed. He wants to get ready. Welcome to Hanover. You ready for the rain day?
Yeah.
They're giving me a scarf, but he has to tell me what it means because I can't read it.
Either one.
Yeah. I'm a Hanover supporter today.
Yeah, you go. It basically means death and hatred to
Braunschweig.
Death and hatred.
Yeah.
So should I be holding this up?
Yes.
Facing them.
Yeah.
Second derby, and I'm already wearing death and hatred. And he taught me how to do this scarf thing. So this is what they hold it up. But if they want to wear it around the neck, you fold it in half, go like this, put it through the little loop, like this. Then you put your shades on, and you start. Hanover main station. We're gonna get some food. Police are already out. Look at this. It's 9 o'clock in the morning this time. So last game was at 1:30. This game is also at 1:30, but this time I'm doing the full experience because I'm getting out with everybody, the real fans, at 9 a.m. and then I'm gonna go to the game 2 hours early and chant and see all that stuff. So I'm gonna bring this camera in there. Should be a good time, and I'm excited. This is my second derby, but this time I'm doing it the right way and I'm wearing the home team colors instead of being in the away block. So we'll see what happens. If a Braunschweig fan is walking around, would they get like beat up?
Possible.
It's possible.
Yeah, yeah.
It's very possible. Now we're at a bakery. Breakfast right here. Oh baby, look at this. That chocolate looks good to me. Donuts, yo. Look at these mini donuts, like as big as my thumb. All right, like I said, I am not from here. I'm here for the entire full experience. I really appreciate Richard taking me around, him and his boys. I'm getting the real experience this time. I got my scarf on for the home team, so I'm not gonna be in the away block. I'm gonna be with the homies that are protecting me. Hopefully it's as rowdy as last game, but hey, thank you for watching the video. Come along with me for the ride. Let's do it. Typical beer. Hanover beer, you say?
Harry, best in.
Best in Hanover. Best. Let me see this. It's still early. We're gonna go check out where the hooligans are marching. They got a helicopter in the air, just like last game. And dude, it feels like I'm in like a war of some sort because there was big, fat police cars that are carrying people off to prison, probably jail. This is just the beginning. I got it all on camera for y'all.
Did you hear that, y'all?
No.
It was like kind of like
explosion.
Yeah.
Where? Down there?
Yeah.
They're already lighting stuff up?
Yeah.
Dang, alright. Hooligans of the other team in every stadium have to have a police escort into the stadium, which I didn't get last time. I got the police escort out. Now we're looking at like all these cops and us pretty much just waiting for the show of them walking in. If they come close, I'll check it out. I'll let you know. And this is the crazy thing, like, I'm at a soccer game. I forget that. Like, I see like riot cops and I'm like, holy frick. That thing's freaking
let's
huge!
Go, let's go!
Look at that police car. Whatever that is, it's like a bomb squad. And this is 4 hours before the game starts, and I was mistaken. All these cops are for the Hanover Ultra fans to walk in. Not even the away fans. That's crazy. A straight mob is coming. It's like, it's literally like a river, like a dam broke, and just straight up freaking mobbing down the street. That's why all these people are getting ready. And like these cars, they shoot out water. That's what they told me. Like if it gets too much of a riot, they'll just like spray you with water out of these big ones. And look at these freaking cops coming down. It's go time. Time to go. You hear that, Ish? It's like a bomb, dude. This is a soccer game, guys. Remember that. This is a soccer game. Dude, I'm kind of scared.
Is this what the thing is?
Yeah.
The singing Totenhasen BTS foam.
Yeah, what is that?
Which is on your scarf.
Oh, like they hate the other
team.
We're like in the police cars. The hooligans are freaking coming, and I was scared enough to chill behind here. I'll film a little bit if I can, but I don't want to get too close too soon because I want to go to the game still. You know what I mean? Keeps going. I'm undercover, y'all. I'm trying not to get seen because actually, maybe like 5 to 10 people have come up to me and been like, "Yo, you're the guy from the video."
Connor, I saw your video from Stuttgart.
Yes, yes.
So you thought it was a derby, but this is the derby.
Okay. This is better.
It is better.
He says it's better.
Yeah.
Are they gonna be flares in the stadium?
I don't know.
Okay.
But they will try it.
They'll try it.
All right.
Good to meet you. We're about 2 hours out from the game. It's pretty much the same situation as we had last week at Stuttgart. See these fans right here? They're walking all the way down this street, right, to the stadium. There's the top of the stadium right there. And I heard that sometimes when the hooligans, you know, they want to get in the fireworks and all the illegal stuff, they'll rush the gate. People who've been banned from the stadium, people who have, you know, illegal fireworks and stuff like that, that's how they get them in. A lot of the times, because otherwise they'll pat you down and they'll take those things and ban you from the stadium if they find you with them. This is Alex.
What's
and,
up?
And I'm gonna put the camera away because as you can see, it's hailing and it's wet. Get your drinks in before you get in.
Hey.
fans wouldn't be close together because he said it's a bloody rivalry. And if you look at the seats, you wonder that there's something wrong because there's literally thousands of seats between the two fans. The Hanover Ultras, which is my team, home team, is on my left. And then the Browns White fans are on the right. Dude, there's hundreds of riot police all around them, way more than in Stuttgart. In Stuttgart, when I was in the KSC block, there was no riot police. There was just regular security. Up there, you can see all these riot police, just waiting there, just in case anything goes down. Okay, other thing too, this stadium was built. It was built for the 2006 World Cup, so pretty cool. Historic stadium. Hear them chanting already?
They were doing whatever they had to do
to get their little fire sticks out, and they lit them up. But hey, we got some fire. That's what we want to see, man. We want to see some energy and some fire in the crowd. Now I'm gonna go up to the very top. I got a little bit of battery left. Show you what's up. See what's happening up here. Look at these guys chanting. Crazy. But like, you see those empty pockets like to my left? They don't have fans there on purpose. So like the fans below and the fans above won't fight because this is like a blood rivalry. That's what someone told me. So pretty crazy. They already got whatever you call it, riot police already ready down here. 1-0, I should be watching. It's like an intense rivalry. Check it. Way. I'm like right above the ultras. They're all below me, like right here. That's where the fire was. And I'm hanging off the edge of the stadium too. So if I fall, I'm dead, but it's worth the view. They literally gave the other player an umbrella because they were throwing balls at him. That's crazy. I love it though. But if they wouldn't have won, they would be booing. I'm glad they won. Yo, look at this. They're pretty much preparing for war. Big freaking police cars, they got tanks on the other side. Nope, just a soccer game.